We're going to use several different firing techniques so you can see different ways to burn a field.
A back and fire moves against the wind. It slowly backs into the wind, and so it's much slower, but that means the residence time is longer. Thus, you generally get better consumption of the fuels than you do with a heading fire that is moving the fire much more quickly, oftentimes just burning the material that's on the upper layer of fuels. Always start the fire on the downwind side adjacent to a fire break. No exceptions. Allow an area to blacken like you see here, and allow the fire to back into the wind. This is what we call a backing fire. With a longer residence time with the backing fire, it's consuming the fuel really well. And if you watch, see, all of the thatch is gone. All you have here is a little bit of ash, which will add a little bit of nutrient to the site once it rains, but it's really negligible. This is burned off completely. A problem here is honey locust. This fire top killed the honey locust, but here in another 2 or 3 weeks, it will sprout back out. So it will be necessary to come back in here and spot spray these honey locusts to kill them. The landowner doesn't like changing tires, which they're having to do fairly frequently on ATVs because the spines will flatten the tire quickly. If you want to burn the field a little more quickly, you can use a strip heading fire. And with a strip heading fire, you just come out from the backing fire and run a strip across, and you have a short head fire going into your backing fire. An issue with this is that sometimes you don't get as good of consumption of the fuels, it'll just burn the fuels on the top of the ground. And that's particularly true if the fine fuels near the ground are moist. We just showed you a strip heading fire that we ran over this area. Look, we didn't get complete consumption of the fuels because the flames are moving relatively quickly over the top, and you don't have enough residence time to completely consume the fine fuels. Now, it isn't a big problem in this situation. Obviously, this is all dead because it was sprayed before we burned, and this will decompose and fresh growth will come up. But in some areas, it can be an issue where you have enough thatch remaining that it inhibits the seed bank from germinating as you would hope it would. We've got a backing fire here. It's slowly backing into the wind and down the slope. That gives you really good fuel consumption, but if you're wanting to burn the field a little more quickly, you could either use a strip heading fire or a flanking fire. Sometimes a strip heading fire will burn a little too quickly, and you'll just get the fuels up on top burn, and you'll keep a thatch layer down low. But if you use a flanking fire and burn perpendicular with the wind, in a large field that you don't want to take the time to allow a backing fire to go all the way across the field, you can use a flanking fire and let it split, and you'll get good fuel consumption and speed up the firing process. We finished burning the field, a field of tall fescue, orchard grass, and brome grasses that we sprayed a few weeks ago. Our main take-home message for you is to burn on the downwind side of the area that you're burning, adjacent to your fire break on the downwind side. Use a backing fire to get that fire away from your fire break and create a good blackened area. So then you can use strip heading fires or a flanking fire if you choose to do so, and burn the field a little more quickly.